So we're just gonna make up a quick batch of Halloween soap. It's scented. The scents are volcano type, orange and goji berry, forever romance, masquerade, and then a little bit of love spell. Our colors are nurture soap pink vibrance, TKB neon red, nurture soap glow in the dark powder, which is in the pink, as well as will be just in a plain. Then we've got amethyst purple mica from Wholesale Supplies Plus. Ye Olde Neon Purple from TKB. Matte Black Oxide from Wholesale Supplies Plus. And then we've got Black Knight Mica from Wholesale Supply Plus. So the soap, at least right now, the plan is black is the dominant color. Then purple and pink mixed within it, and as well as a little bit of the plain with glow in the dark. Doing basically an in the pot swirl, and then piping on top, again the same color scheme, just mix together the leftover and pipe it. And then we will embed our witch's legs. So these were melt and pour that we've been painted with mica. And hope dust with some glitter, maybe. We'll hope that it turns out like I think it will. is such a pretty color. And I know I'll have to refill. But that is a bit intentional. Oops, make a mess. Now that I've made a mess on the countertop, the rest of this, I really am making a mess. Probably I'm not this messy. The rest is gonna go just randomly back in here because this will be my piping. And I want the mixture of colors and textures to be there, but I do want it mostly black. Really do love this combination of the pink. I know it probably doesn't show on the camera, but this is just popping. So I hope it really does turn out this kind of color. And the plane is, this color right here is just the glow-in-the-dark powder, which will give a nice bit of texture. And then here's our purple, which I hope comes back to a vibrancy instead of this muddy purple. Not caring for this color right now, so I really do hope that it comes back. It usually does, but one never knows until we see. Now I get to clean up a little bit while I wait for this to harden so that I can pipe this. Let me smooth this back down in here. I'm just gonna let that sit up for a bit and we'll be back. So the interesting thing about this is I haven't even left this 5 minutes since I was last in here. And it's already ready to go as far as piping goes. So when I said this particular mix sets up quickly, I meant it. It's kind of crazy. It's nice sometimes when you're doing just something simple, but I don't know that I'll ever master batch this particular batch again. Let me get this out of the way. You know, it's been nice and it's great on the skin. The conditioning's wonderful, but just doesn't leave you any time at all to really work. And I'm about out of piping bags, so this one's smaller than I would normally have liked to have used, but it'll work. I'll just refill it a couple times. So when I said it firmed up quickly, I really do mean it. Let's see. Tell you what, let's just start with this one and we'll come back. Thank you. top a little too high. Definitely got this top too high. Not happy with this. It is so high. That I keep. Oh, I guess I should have thought about that. Stuck these too close together. But I was making this for certain people, so I wanted a certain number, but in terms of the look inside, it's very cute. Much thinner than I would have liked it, but I needed 12 of them. Thank you. That's how it turned out. I kind of like it. It's darker than I typically would make, but I did make it way too tall. Way too tall. But live and learn.